here's what I have to say. If you are ever placed in the position of being told that who you are is so wrong and so broken that someone else wants to make you fix it, then you need to have the strength, if you can, to look that person in the face and tell them no. This is not acceptable. You cannot judge me so deeply that you literally, fundamentally want to change who I am.
So I grew up in rural Mississippi, where it was really not okay to be gay. I had a single parent mom for most of my adolescence. And then one day we were at home and my mom called me out on it. She asked me if I were gay because she had listened in on the phone conversation. And I just remember crying. And I knew when I was 13 I was gay, but I had to say I didn't know, just because I knew it would break her heart.
The first time that I remember meeting a gay person or someone close acknowledged that they were gay to me was actually my best friend in college, and I had no idea that he was gay. And when I found out, I was totally ashamed the way that I handled it, the way that I carried myself. And because of my behavior, I made being an ally to the GLBT community as one of my life passions. I felt that I should do something because I did not treat my friend in the way that I know that he should have been treated.
I didn't really get the choice to come out. I was outed. But after being outed, I went through a very, very, very rough time with my family. My family is Baptist.
When I actually came out to my brother, the first thing he said was, I knew something was wrong with you. And he Facebooked me some Bible verses from Leviticus, of all places, that condemned homosexuality.
At home, it was kind of like my family would say something wrong about it, and they would know. But like, I didn't necessarily count that as bullying. My sisters would say something that would be kind of teasing about it. But I kind of just sat them down and was like, look, you can't do that. Like, to anybody, not just me.
The hardest thing to do, the hardest thing you will probably ever do, is treat people better than they treat you. That's a lesson that even my mother didn't learn. She wasn't strong enough to treat me better than I treated her. And a few years ago, she broke my heart. And you don't really get over that. But I built a family here, a new family. And that was really hard.
One of the things we sometimes forget is that parents can also be bullies. And when that is the case, that's when a person is most at risk for really suffering for who they are.
A few years ago, the woman I was dating and living with committed suicide. And I found her at the scene, and it was difficult because I was not able to accompany her to the hospital. I found out about her funeral on Facebook, which I don't think would ever have happened to a straight male partner she'd been with.
When I was found out at the Christian school that I was gay, the people that I sat with at lunch, it was a very small school, there was only 5 people in my grade alone, 25 people in the high school. It was just me and another girl that sat at the table once people found out about me, because she was the only one that actually cared enough to still have a relationship with me.
The cheerleaders used to protect me from the bullies. And it was odd because they were dating them at the time. But yeah, I was physically abused, you know, chased around the fields. You know, it was a game. It was Smear the Queer.
I was rather tomboyish growing up. I didn't understand what fashion was. And I had a favorite pair of black basketball high tops that I insisted on wearing. And I was made fun of a lot for wearing those shoes. And now that I'm older, I reflect back on it, and what I know was happening is that I was being made fun of because I wasn't conforming to proper gender roles.
I have been bullied and teased because I am a recovering stutterer. When I was little, I could not say two words back to back without stuttering. I was teased by my parents, my peers, anyone who saw me made fun of the little girl who stuttered.
I was just one of those kids, right? That no matter what I did, I felt like I drew the attention of the wrong people.
I didn't really meet a lot of different types of people until I came to college.
I have had some of the best experiences at Tech with no one giving a rat's about if I'm gay or not.
I didn't even bring up the subject of my gender, except that I'm female, but I didn't bring up being trans until I'd been here for several months.
Coming here, I've seen a very enthusiastic student group. What I haven't seen so much is a faculty presence.
Pride Alliance and other people at Georgia Tech are constantly trying to make it a more accepting place, which is an effort that I've definitely felt.
I would love to see a dedicated office here on this campus for our GLBTQ students. They have many programs and many events, but sometimes they're not sustainable.
We spend a lot of time helping people understand that their personal lives, their professional lives, and their community lives are integrated.
I'm a firm believer that one person can and one person does make a difference.
I think every day I try to portray my authentic self to campus. I'm not the kind of person to necessarily wave my identity on a banner as I walk through Georgia Tech's campus, but I also don't hide it.
I'm excited because I'm actually working with some Greek allies to put a Greek ally program into the Greek communities.
Within my own fraternity, I've kind of seen what happens when one person stands up and kind of says, guys, this is not okay. We need to be accepting and we need to support our brothers.
It's not just about being gay or a lesbian. It's about being a human. Each person that's earned their way into the Georgia Tech community has the right to be here and to be who they are while they're here.
I think it's all of our responsibilities to ensure that our community is inclusive and that everyone feels a part of the Georgia Tech community.
Nobody had really been out in the athletic department at all. And I guess coming out as a student athlete was pretty enriching, unique experience.
Coming out is all about being true to yourself and then being okay with whatever identity that you have. Because like for me, I really wanted to be straight for forever, right? I really wanted to get married to a guy and have babies in that way, right? So for me, it was hard to accept and believe in myself that it was okay.
I guess there's like the initial coming out, then there's just this whole like almost lifelong process, you know?
Yeah.
For me, coming out was kind of like breaking the surface of water after you've been holding your breath underwater for a really, really long time. When everything breaks open, everything breaks down.
Not to be sure. It's okay not to know who I'm attracted to. It's okay to not be attracted to anybody sometimes. It's okay to feel like you're attracted to everybody.
My current significant other is transgender, female to male. We actually met on Facebook through the Georgia Tech freshman group, and we just got to talking. We've talked pretty much every day since then. I identify as pansexual, which is, for anybody who doesn't know, because sometimes people aren't familiar with that term, it's the same idea as bisexual, but it includes all genders, whether you're genderqueer, transgender, gender fluid, like it includes that, like instead of just being like a binary system.
I like boys, but girls are cool too. I think the question of sexuality is really complicated.
What you see isn't who I am. It's inside is who I am, and it doesn't matter what my gender is. You should just accept me how I am.
One of the toughest journeys for me so far as a lesbian has been reconciling my sexual orientation with my faith. I tried to pray myself into being straight. I had a boyfriend for 2.5 years that I thought for sure would turn me into a man-loving woman. And, you know, it just wasn't changing. And when I started going to different churches, I realized, holy cow, there are people who are Christians who love gay people. And it's okay. And God loves me. God doesn't hate me. For the longest time, I felt like a piece of gum on God's shoe.
I have had moments where I thought, I can't do this anymore. And the only thing that there are a lot of things, but one of the biggest things that keeps me from doing that is realizing that there are other people out there just like me, and that they're suffering too, and it's important for me to connect to those people.
Things will be bad for a little while, and things will be uncomfortable, and you'll feel like, oh my god, I'm the only person in the world who feels like this. But it gets better, you know? Like, you'll find other people who will be like, that's exactly how I felt. Like, I felt isolated. I felt like I was the only person in the world. And, it'll be the most amazing feeling ever to be able to connect with these other people and say, like, me too, you know?
I think I help myself feel better by sharing my story and showing where I am now and what I do, and letting other people's vent and tell me their story and let them see that they've come a long way from where they started.
I remember one time I was talking to my mom about, you know, how bad I felt. And she just reminded me, Emma, there are so many people out there who really care about you, and I know you don't feel like it right now, but they're there. And think about how much it's going to hurt them if you're just gone. Because, you know, people aren't like these isolated structures ever.
My mother always said, and I live by this quote, and this carries me on forever, the most important thing in your life is not what you are called, but what you choose to answer to.
So what you need to know if you're in the process of coming out is that if your family doesn't support you, there are people who do support you.
One place of support on campus certainly would be the counseling center. Even if they're just questioning, I think that's one of the big things sometimes, that students who are questioning don't know where to go.
And I just hope that everybody knows that we're all here to help each other.
If, you know, the first person isn't the one who hears you, then scream a little louder until somebody does.
It gets better each and every day.
It gets better because you find friends and you find creative outlets. You learn to dance and play the guitar.
You discover who you are and what you are, and you get to determine that for yourself.
I could go back to talk to my younger self. I think that I would have been so relieved during those years to know just not only does it get better, but exactly how much better it got.
If I'm just living my life as the woman I am, and it's not a big deal to me, then it's not a big deal to other people.
There are times when I have actually thought about being gay as a blessing in my life.
And it gets better because you find people who love you, and they love you for who you are.
One day, you're going to fall in love, and, you know, maybe not that day at that time, but eventually someone else will love you back.
3 years ago, I wouldn't have even thought I would have someone. Just because. You're
gonna make me cry.
You know you're gonna make me cry.
No, I don't.
but like, I didn't even think I was gonna have anybody who would want to sit here through this and like deal with the dysphoria and the issues that come up. But I have her, and it gets better.
The negativity doesn't stop, but it does stop with you. You have to turn it around. You have to be an ambassador every day, and that sucks. But you have to buck it up for the rest of us, because we bucked it up for you. You have to be better.
I think having a positive attitude towards things helps a lot. Have a smile and it'll make you better.
There is no language for how I feel. There is no language for how I feel. Yeah. When I look at you standing there, none of this seems real. There is no language for how I feel.
I am a fifth-year business administration major.
My name is Archie Urban, and I'm vice president for Institute Diversity.
I'm Ellie Creel. I'm a fourth-year business administration major, and I'm the undergraduate student body president.
My name is Tody Perez, and I'm the director of the Counseling Center.
My name is Karen Head, and I'm the director of the Communication Center.
I'm Rebecca Burnett. I'm the director of Writing and Communication.
I'm Teresa Crocker. I'm the chief of police.
My name is Joe Dombowski. I am a building construction major.
My name is Robin Wharton, and I'm the assistant director of Writing and Communication.
I'm Britta Spann, and I'm a Britton Fellow.
My name is Normal Trevetti. I'm a postdoc.
Billy Pendleton Parker. I'm the assistant director of our President's Scholarship Program.
I'm Eric Chu. I'm 21. I'm a 30.
My name is Jonathan Duke. I am an alum. Now I'm the coordinator of New Student Programs.
I'm Justin Keating. I came to Georgia Tech from San Antonio, Texas.
My name's Jen Oh, and I'm a second year.
My name's Jenny Howard, and I'm assistant administrator.
My name is Katie Kim. I'm a fifth year.
I'm Nicholas Bunsman. I graduated from Georgia Tech.
I'm Daniel. I'm a fourth year.
My name is Tanner Marcantel. I'm an assistant dean of students.
My name is Danny Ingram, and I am the national president of American Veterans for Equal Rights.
Philip Miller, and I'm a third year chemical engineer.
My name's Chelsea McClinton, and I'm a fourth-year computational media major.
My name is Stephanie Knight, and I'm the interim director of the Office of Student Involvement.
My name is Julie Champion. I'm a fifth-year biomedical engineering student and the president of Pride Alliance.
My name is Jesse Stommel, and I'm a teacher at Georgia Tech.
My name is Brad Wilkinson, and I'm an alumni.
I'm Philip Rafshin.
I graduated from Georgia Tech. I own and operate Outright Booster.
I'm Chad Sleeper, and I'm a 2002 graduate.
My name is Drew Childs. I'm a graduating senior.
My name is Yvette Upton. I'm the director of Outreach.
I'm Alex Wan. I went to Georgia Tech. I serve on the Atlanta City Council.
My name is Rebecca Glatzer. I am a graduate.
My name's Lauren Curtwright, and I'm a Marion L. Britton postdoctoral fellow.
I'm Martha Reed. I'm a student.
My name is Jake Rosser, and I'm an undergraduate.
My name is Ty Autry. I am a double major electrical and computer engineer.
My name is Sui Belton. I'm a student at Georgia Tech.
I'm Kate Harlan. I'm a second year computer science student.
My name is Adrienne Clagg, and I am a computational media major.
My name is Emma Hyland, and I'm a freshman at Georgia Tech.
My name is Stephanie Ray, and I am the associate dean of students.
My name is John Douglas, and I'm a senior systems architect working in OIT.
My name is Air, and I am a first year aerospace major at the Georgia Institute of Technology.